I'm Max Sterling. Welcome to LARPgasm. I recently ordered some weapons for my friends over at Nighthawk Armories. So, I have a post-apocalyptic game coming up soon. It's a Fallout-based airsoft LARP, which is still in beta testing, which is actually the coolest game I've ever played. And I also have a Dystopia Rising game coming up at the end of the month as well. So, a bunch of games coming up. So, I wanted to order some cool sort of urban, you know, dystopian, future, cyberpunk, post-apocalyptic weapons that I can use in a variety of these sort of future-type LARPs. So, I was going to order, like, some big weapons and stuff, and then I thought to myself, you know what? I'm going to focus primarily on guns, and, like, that Fallout game is an airsoft LARP, so it's mostly airsoft guns. And Dystopia Rising, you know, I'm going to have a Nerf gun, and, you know, I'm not going to really try to be a big combat guy in that game, if I can try. So, I got smaller weapons, which is very unusual for me, but one of the weapons I ordered was this throwing knife, the Ripley throwing knife, and it's basically all foam, there's no core, it's Calimacil, and I got it because that way there's no maintenance, I don't have to worry about it. If I want to put it in a sheath, it's not going to get messed up, and that's why I got this knife, because I wanted to check it out. And the other blade I got is probably the coolest, in my opinion, the coolest weapon I've seen, and that's this one, the Sly or the Commando knife. Now, this knife to me is freaking awesome. I'm telling you, just holding this, this feels awesome. I feel almost like I got a real knife in my hand, and it looks really good. I mean, that is a knife. If any of you are wondering what a comparison on the Sly and the Ripley look like in real life, well, there you go. Ripley, Sly. So, there is no comparison. This is a little throwing knife, and this is an actual weapon. I can tell you right now, let's talk about this Ripley first, I do not like this. I straight hate this. Look at this thing. What a fucking flaccid, sad little thing. I mean, I guess if you're holding it, it still, like, looks cool and, you know, it has the shape and stuff, but really, where's my... Alright, so here's that knife I made in that other video. And this is actually about a year old at this point in time. And here's this Ripley. So actually, if you look at this, these are pretty close. The difference is, this one is not a weird flaccid thing. This feels like a knife. This feels like I'm holding a gummy worm. But let me throw these real quick. Yeah, I mean, I'll tell you what, they both hit exactly where I was aiming, so I guess it'll be okay as a throwing knife, but it just seems weird. Like, the other knife I could stick in my boot, stick in my hat, stick in a sheath or a holster of some kind, and it's fine because it's solid, but that wiggly, wobbly one, I'd be afraid of it worming its way out of wherever I put it. I'm going to have to keep that in a pocket or tie a string to it or something. It's just weird. So, I don't know. If you want some throwing weapons, those Ripleys certainly are cheap enough. You know, they're under $20. I mean, if you go on Nighthawk Armory site, they are. I don't know what other sites are hawking them for, but they're certainly under $20. I mean, it looks good. It still seems like a good blade. It seems like it's a fine throwing weapon. It's just a little weird to me. I don't like that floppiness to it. But whatever. That was a side thing anyways, because that wasn't very expensive. This is the knife I wanted. Yeah. This is Calimacil. And to tell you the truth, I straight hated this brand when I first encountered it. I hated the name, you know, I didn't like the looks of the stuff, I just really thought they sucked. Until I did that review, and I think it was a Viking short sword on my one review video I did for Nighthawk Armories, and I realized that these are actually really nice blades. The fact that you don't have to maintain them really is awesome, because as much as I love Epic Armory and some of these other brands, that latex coating, it rubs off. I'm not very good at maintaining my swords. like my epic armory swords I have, I use the noble sword, which I think is a very good looking sword. I use two of them because I fight dual long swords at most games I go to. And those things have lasted for 3 years of some serious LARPing, and they held up real good the first year, but then like the second year they started breaking down, and by the third year, like tons of the latex is off of them. There's all kinds of holes in the end. I've had to glue pieces back on several times. I've had to re-glue the tips and all kinds of stuff. And that's even spraying them with the silicone lubricant, but they still got so fucked up. But the good thing is, they still look really nice. I mean, unless you actually look close up, they actually still look really nice. I get compliments on them all the time, which is great, but from a safety standpoint and from a maintenance standpoint, they need some serious work done to them. But that's a video for another time. Calimacil, you don't have to worry about any of that shit. I can keep this in a sheath or a holster. I can hit this on trees and stuff, and it's not going to get fucked up because there's no coatings. I don't have to spray it with shit and get it all over my costume, and that's awesome. And, you know, what more can I say? I mean, yes, they hit a little harder, but they are nice and solid. I think that I can probably block basically anything incoming with this. Unless I'm at one of my fucking goon LARPs where teenage kids in basketball shorts are doing, like, fucking 180, like, jump hammer strikes with two-handed weapons. I don't think I'm going to block that shit with this. But any normal LARP where people are 45-degree angles or even 90-degree angles, I don't think I have a problem blocking a longsword or maybe even a two-handed weapon. I'm pretty strong. Like, if your arm's not strong, you'd probably get it knocked back into you. But I think I could block just about anything with this, and that is a good thing. So that's why I got this weapon. I knew it would be solid. I knew it would look great. Now, as far as some games, I'll have to do a little bit of genre stuff to it. I'll probably wrap some stuff around it. I'm not going to paint it or mess with it, but I'll wrap some stuff around it, maybe wrap some stuff around the handle. I'm definitely going to put some 550 paracord through this hole. Not sure what this is for precisely, and I hope that the paracord doesn't damage this, but definitely going to put some of that through it so it's hanging down off of there, just to sort of further add to that look, and plus it's something very easy to do. I think this is going to be pretty good. I just got to get used to having a... I don't know. How big is this thing? Let me check something. I'd say, I don't know, this is probably like about 20 inches. Maybe a little bit longer than 20 inches in size. So, you know, it's very short compared to what I'm used to working with, which is my 44-inch longsword, so I gotta get used to working with something half the size. So I guess we'll see how that goes. I expect I'm gonna get hit a lot, but whatever, we'll see how it goes. That's why I have a gun, so if I get in close, I'll use this. If I'm within 21 feet, if I'm more than 21 feet, bust out the assault rifle, hose them down with that. So we'll see how it goes. So I just got back from my fall at LARP, and I had a chance to test this Commando knife, the Sly by Calimacil. Now, what I did was I, of course, put the paracord on it like I said I was going to. I also put a carabiner on the end of it. This way, I could keep it in that cool sheath that I made, but I could also just hang it off of stuff like my armor if I needed to have quick access to it. Actually, most of the time, I found myself holding it in my teeth when I was trying to reload or shoot, so it definitely... got to be used in many different creative ways. I don't suggest probably holding it in your teeth because I don't know what is really on this, but you know, sometimes in the heat of the moment, shit happens. No teeth marks though from me biting into it, so definitely good item. It's Calimacil, good stuff. I ended up with one little mark on it, but you know, it's irrelevant. If this was a latex weapon, this was from a Jagger bush, then the coating may have been compromised. I may have had to seal it, but because it's Calimacil, don't have to worry about that. So, good brand of stuff. This is a very cool blade. If you play this type of genre enough to justify this type of weapon, I would save up and buy one. If you have money to spend, just buy it. It is a great blade. It is very cool. If you have to be a little bit more frugal or you don't play this type of genre enough to justify something like this, keep an eye out for a good deal. You know, maybe you can find one on sale or something, depending on what promotions are going on. If you check out Nighthawk Armory, which I've done reviews for in the past. It's www.latex-weaponry.com. If you check them out, they do free shipping, so you know maybe you can get a good deal there. I would definitely recommend this, though, for anyone who is interested in getting a weapon like this. As far as the Ripley, the little throwing knife, I actually chose not to take that with me. It was snowy out. It has a brown handle and it's, you know, black blade. And considering leaves on the ground and snow mount, I was just afraid I was going to lose it. I didn't really feel like tossing a 20, you know, into the snow and losing it. So I didn't even take it with me. Also, I think I mentioned I don't really care for that blade anyhow. And honestly, I think when I tossed it the other day, I think it went behind my washer dryer. And I don't even know where it is at this point in time, so I'll have to find it. But yeah, the little Ripley blade, I don't know. If you have money to blow or you get a good deal on them, I'd probably pick them up because they still look cool, but the floppiness is weird. But they still fly good. So that one, I'm going to leave up to you. Maybe see if you can find someone who already has one and check it out and see if it's your thing or not. For me, I think I'm just going to stick with the little ones I make in my garage. But Commando knife, definitely a thumbs up. So if you like this video, please click like, subscribe to my channel. I have plenty of reviews and all kinds of LARP content, and I don't plan on slowing down anytime soon. You know, if you've been watching my channel, you know, it's at least one video, but more realistically, it's like two or three videos a week that I'm putting out. So I intend to try to keep up, you know, the pace as long as I can. As far as the subscription, if you want to be notified when my videos come out, click the little bell. If you don't click the bell, it won't tell you when they happen. You can check me out on Twitter. I post on there, you know, infrequently, but I always post on there when there's new videos going up on my channel. And if you have anything to comment, you know, or any questions, please feel free to do so below. I'm pretty good at answering them. And I appreciate you watching my show. And as always, adventure on. I'm Max Sterling, and this is my channel. I work here with my old man and my son, Big Hoss. Everything in here has a story and a price. One thing I've learned after 21 years is that you never know what is going to come through that door.